The president also weighed in on the NFL and referenced Colin Kaepernick, formerly with the San Francisco 49ers, who drew national attention for refusing to stand during the Star Spangled Banner. I want you to take a listen to what the president said.
Wouldn't you love to see one of these NFL owners, when somebody disrespects our flag, to say, get that son of a bitch off the field right now, out, he's fired. He's fired! The only thing you could do better is if you see it, even if it's one player, leave the stadium. I guarantee things will stop. Things will stop. Just pick up and leave. Pick up and leave.
Mark, what do you make of this kind of message coming from the President of the United States?
This may be one of the most vile and disgusting things that President Trump has ever said, in a very long and impressive list of vile and disgusting things. To call people exercising their First Amendment rights to protest injustice sons of bitches, when you don't have that kind of language. He didn't have that kind of language for Al-Qaeda when they were cutting Americans' heads off. He didn't have that kind of language for people who were white supremacist, anti-Semite walking through Charlottesville. In fact, he called them very fine people. So an anti-Semite is a very fine person, and somebody who's protesting injustice and violence against vulnerable people is somehow an SOB. That is a terrible language. It is a disgusting language, but it's reflective of a deep white supremacist impulse in Donald Trump's mind, spirit, body, and politics.
Mark is not the only one voicing that, Matt. Bakari Sellers, you know him well, said he tweeted this out tonight. He says, y'all remember Charlottesville, white supremacists, very fine people, black NFL players, sons of bitches that need to be fired. What do you say, Matt?
Well, I look, first of all, I said there's no doubt that Donald Trump has this weird, intensity towards certain things. And you know, he gives, has he ever said anything bad about Vladimir Putin? I don't know. But let's put that aside, because I think you're right about that. That's a fair point. Bakari scores one there. I actually agree with him on the NFL, though. I've quit watching the NFL myself. I've got hours of time on Sundays free. It's amazing what happens when you don't. When you don't watch the Redskins lose every week. But look, I think, you know, there's a lot of reasons to sort of be upset with the NFL right now. You could be concussions. But one of it is, you know, these are the people who have fought and died for this country. We just had 9/11 a couple weeks ago. And here you have millionaire NFL players that I am paying money to, like, wear their jerseys and watch on TV, who are not even willing to stand up for our national anthem. I do think that's a problem. And look, if you are an employee and you're putting on, if I own the San Francisco 49ers or whatever, and you're part of the NFL, you're part of my league, you're putting on our uniform, you're on the job, and you're not going to stand up.
Okay, let me make a point. Hold on, Mark. Because as you were saying that, I was thinking there are millions of people of color who are at home saying the exact same thing about President Trump. Mm-hmm. You're a millionaire / billionaire who's put on the suit to be the leader of the free world, and still you can't stand up to bigotry and racism and white supremacists and anti-Semites and call them sons of bitches. Instead, you call people who are protesting the country.
I'm not a big fan of Donald Trump either.
Why the double standard here? Why the double standard? Don't you understand why some people feel that way about him?
I'm not a fan of Donald Trump either, but I would be very upset if he refused to stand for our Pledge of Allegiance.
But you still come here and you defend him. You do at times defend him.
Sure, of course.
You're not defending the NFL. Wholeheartedly, you've just said you just cast out the entire NFL because of, you know, you agree apparently what the president says. Couldn't the same be said about the president, what you just said about the NFL?
Matt, do you think that he has the right to do what he's doing?
That Donald Trump has the right to do what he's doing?
No, 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 no.
Or Colin Kaepernick.
Kaepernick.
Well, he does, and he's also out of the NFL because he's not a good quarterback. I think part of this is the publicity
stuff. That has nothing to do with it. He has the right to do this.
If I were the coach, he has the right to do it and to pay the consequences.
And that's fine. But he has the right to do it. And when you have a country where the president of the United States fails time and again to stand up for minority communities, and this is the only way that a person like Kaepernick has that kind of voice to be able to do it on behalf of millions of minority voters in this country.
So the only way he can express himself,
then that says volumes about
the
president.
The only way he can get his message out, the only way he can get his message out is to refuse to stand up and honor this country, all the people who have died defending that flag, so that he has the freedom to be an
idiot. Exactly.
Maybe he's honoring it by paying his taxes. Maybe he's honoring it by...
He has that freedom.
Maybe
he does.
He does. And listen, I think many people agree with you. He suffered the consequences, but he has the right to do it. But I think your facts are wrong when you're saying he's not a great quarterback. I think it doesn't. The facts don't bear it.
I think it's pretty... He was once very good. I'll give him that.
It's a couple of things. First of all, several years ago, he was in the Super Bowl. There are people right now holding clipboards as third string NFL quarterbacks who are literally working at department stores last year. To suggest that Colin Kaepernick is not one of the, say, I don't know, 70 best quarterbacks in the world is just absurd. But it's also absurd to say that he's not in the NFL because he's not a good quarterback. He's clearly being blacklisted. He's clearly being blackballed here. Yeah. And you say, yes, you talk about NFL owners. NFL owners own teams. They don't own NFL players. But part of the problem is this plantation logic that says that we are somehow, because we're your employer, we somehow own you and we can determine your actions. He has
Do you
a
think
First
CNN
Amendment
could
right?
fire me? Do you think CNN could fire me if, if I tweeted something inappropriate? Come on. Am I on a plantation?
Yeah, name people.
Is this my plantation? Because I could get fired if I did something or said
something
stupid.
Do you think that they would fire you for not standing up for the? That's a whole different thing. You're comparing two different.
They could.
Things.
You know what? They very well. They would have the right to do it. They could do it.
I don't think that CNN would fire you for that. But
first of all, I come on here every week and talk about white supremacy. I say Donald Trump's a white supremacist. I don't stand for the national anthem, and CNN still employs me. You have a right to do that. It's not a plantation logic to have rules. It's a plantation logic to think that you can control people's minds and bodies and politics, which is what they're attempting to do with Colin Kaepernick. Also, not standing for the national anthem is not inappropriate or wrong. It's simply something you have a different point of view on.
It's unpatriotic is what it is.
Let me respond to that. Okay, first of all, patriot, you don't get to define patriotism for everybody else. People didn't die for the right to stand for a flag. They died for freedom and justice. And Colin Kaepernick is putting his knee down because there is an insufficient amount of freedom and justice for vulnerable black and brown people. When somebody dies in this country, we put the flag at half mast. We have a flag, but we put it at half mast. Colin Kaepernick's body is standing at half mast every time he puts his knee on the ground because he's saying that America is not free yet. And yes, he's a millionaire and athlete. That's why we should be honoring him. He has everything to lose. Colin Kaepernick has privilege. He has access. He has money.
Why didn't he do this when he was in the Super Bowl? Why didn't he do this when he actually was a good quarterback? In fact, a great quarterback. Very good. He didn't do it then. Why is he doing it now that it doesn't matter?
Would it have bothered you less if he had done it then?
No, it wouldn't have bothered me less. But
I think it's money. Let him get plenty of money. He can buy TV time.
Maria for the win on that one. I think that there's a very good answer to that because maybe when he was winning, there were, you know, people, there weren't the high profile cases of people being killed that we saw. So anyway,
it's the time we're living.
Thank you all. I have to go.
Thanks, Don.
Great conversation. We come back. Former football player weighs in on what President Trump said tonight about the NFL and players who protest the national anthem. President Trump's comments tonight about NFL players who protest the national anthem setting off a storm of criticism. Here to discuss, Marvin Washington, a former NFL player, and CNN analyst, sports analyst Christine Brennan, a columnist for USA Today. So good to have all of you on. I'm sure you heard that conversation before. It was heated. It was very interesting. I want to get your reaction to a comment by the President Trump tonight, just a short while ago, regarding the NFL watches.
Wouldn't you love to see one of these NFL owners, when somebody disrespects our flag, to say, get that son of a bitch off the field right now. Out. He's fired. He's fired!
So, of course, he's talking about Colin Kaepernick, formerly of the San Francisco 49ers, not standing for the national anthem, taking a knee. What's your response?
Well, I think it's sort of par for the course of 45, and I don't think we need that type of rhetoric right now. Colin Kaepernick is just exercising his First Amendment right and freedom of speech and freedom of expression, and this country was founded on civil disobedience. So Colin Kaepernick is doing something, you know, I grew up during the late 60s, early 70s, and we had the socially conscious athlete, and I think that he's bringing back that tradition, and he's protesting civil rights and social justice, or lack thereof, and I'm for him.
Christine, what do you think?
Don, I think we're going to see potentially more NFL players taking a knee this weekend than we ever would have thought, maybe even college players, too. The reaction, as your show has
exhibited...
Because
of this?
Absolutely. I think that, for example, you have Steph Curry talking about not coming to the White House, and that he's out there with that. I think the reaction is just building. You saw the reaction, obviously, on your show. My sense is that people are going to be angry about this, and that players are angry about it. And they obviously, for all the reasons we've been talking about, the racial connotations, the fact that Trump will talk about this but not other things. So we'll see. But I wouldn't be surprised at all to see more protests this weekend, at least in part because of what the president said.
Do you think the owners and do you think they realize what, and maybe the president, do you think they realize what's happening, that they, instead of, by their criticism, they may be fueling, you know, I wouldn't say backlash, but fueling the protests?
Well, I think the owners are, you know, they pretty much are trying to concentrate on the season and next game. And so they've kind of tampered down talking about him because they're all about, you know, the next game and the next day. But this type of talk right here is going to bring more protests, like Christine said, and it's going to permeate down to the college and the high school level. I can see this happening starting tomorrow and going on to Sunday and Monday.
You think it should?
I think players should have the right to express themselves, and I think they will, to a certain extent.